subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. You students, like you, especially MCET students, has been requesting me to make a video on 30 days preparation timetable, like a preparation schedule for MCET. Okay, so here we are. First, let's see what is the study schedule, like 30 days study schedule for MPC students. This applies for both AP as well as TS MCET. Okay. And after this, let's see what is the 30 days study schedule for BIPC students. Okay, so now let's begin this video without any delay. Okay, so first of all, coming to the MPC students, day one, this is the timing, and here is the schedule, like what you need to do at that particular time. Okay, it comes under schedule. Okay, coming to the day one, wake up at morning 6 a.m. like this should be your like study start time. Okay, so 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. you have to practice the problems of algebra, because morning you will feel fresh and you can go ahead with your mathematics, and also keep reading all your formulae, because early in the morning, whatever you study, you will remember it for a long time and you will also learn it in the shorter period. Okay, so day one, morning 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. start with your algebra, and after 1 hour of your study, from 7 to 8 a.m. Just fresh up and have your breakfast, and from 8 to 10 again, continue with your algebra, like practice the problems. From 10 to 11, take a short break. From 11 to 1, study the concept of the physical world. Okay, under physics, there's a concept, there's a chapter called physical world. From 11 to 1, study this concept, physical world, and from 1 to 2 you can take a lunch break, and from 2 to 4 resume back to your studies and start your preparation like atomic structure from chemistry, and from 4 to 5 you can take 1 hour of a break, and from 5 to 7 you can again start preparing with your physical world, and from 7 to 8 you can again take a short break, and from 8 to 9 whatever you studied since morning, just revise it thoroughly. Okay, so what is the advantage of revision at the end of the day is, whatever you study, you can memorize them as soon as you revise. Okay, so revision is very, very important. So coming to the day 2, from morning 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. again do with your algebra. From 7 to 8 as usual break. From 8 to 10 again go with your algebra. From 10 to 11 take break. From 11 to 1 units and measurements, do this chapter. Okay. From 1 to 2 as usual break. From 2 to 4 go with atomic structure. From 4 to 5, take a break. From 5 to 7, again, study the concept and the questions, like bits of units and measurements. And from 7 to 8, go with your break. And from 8 to 9, revise the things which you have already studied the entire day. Okay. So coming to the day 3, from 6 to 7, again, algebra. From 8 to 10, algebra. I'm not repeating the break timings, students. Okay, so I'm not repeating this break timings, like 7 to 8. Of course, it's break every day, so I'm not repeating it. From 11 to 1, like start the concept of motion in a straight line. It's very, very important concept. And from 2 to 4, go with your classification of elements and periodicity in properties. Okay, so if you want to just have a screenshot, you can pause the video and take a quick screenshot, no issues. And from 4 to 5 again break. From 5 to 7 again revise your like study the concept of motion in a straight line from 8 to 9, again you have to revise. Okay, this is the day 3 schedule. And coming to the day 4, from 6 to 7, algebra. Algebra is very, very important, students. So first 5 days you have to thoroughly prepare with your algebra. Okay, it's really important. And from 8 to 10 again algebra, because why I have allocated 3 hours for mathematics, that too in the morning schedule, is that's the best time to prepare with your mathematics. Okay, so from 11 to 1 motion in a plane, from 2 to 4 chemical bonding and molecular structure, from 5 to 7 motion in a plane, from 8 to 9 revision. Okay, so coming to the day 5, algebra from 6 to 7 and 8 to 10, and from 11 to 1 you have to go with loss of motion, and even 5 to 7 loss of motion, and in between 2 to 4 you have to study chemical bonding and molecular structure. Okay, so coming to the day 6, from day 6 to day 10 you have the schedule of trigonometry. Okay, from morning 6 to 7 go with trigonometry, from 8 to 10 again trigonometry is very, very important. Okay, so from 11 to 1 go with your work energy and power, and repeat the same in between 5 to 7 also, and from 2 to 4 go with your states of matter, gases and liquids, and last but not least from 8 to 9 have your thorough revision. Okay, so coming to the day 7, morning 7 to 9 and morning 8 to 10 you will do the problems of trigonometry, and from 11 to 1 system of particles and rotational motion, and from 2 to 4 stoichiometry, and from 5 to 7 system of particles and rotational motion, and coming to the day 8 you will again repeat with the trigonometry, and coming to physics from 11 to 1 you'll go with the oscillations, and from 2 to 4 thermodynamics from chemistry, and from 5 to 7 again oscillations, and coming to the day 9 gravitation from physics and thermodynamics from the chemistry. And this is the schedule. You can take a quick screenshot. Okay, so next day 10, coming to day 10, trigonometry. Okay, and this is like day 10 is the last day for your trigonometry, so also make sure you revise all the formulae, because formula is very, very important coming to mathematics. And from 11 to 1 go with your mechanical property of solids, and from 2 to 4 go with your chemical equilibrium and acid bases. Okay, this take a quick screenshot, it's for your day 10. Okay, so coming to the day 11, you will start preparing vector algebra, and coming to 11 to 1 you will start preparing mechanical properties of fluids, and coming to 2 to 4 you'll go with the hydrogen and its compounds, and from 5 to 7 you'll go with mechanical properties of fluids, and last but not least you'll have your revision, quick revision, from 8 to 9 o'clock. From day 12, like in the on day 12 you will have a practice from the vector algebra, and coming to physics from 11 to 1 you'll go with thermal properties of matter, and from 2 to 4 you'll go with s block, p block, f block. These are very, very important. Okay, from here 2 to 4 you'll go with s block elements, and from 5 to 7 you'll go with thermal properties of matter, and there's a quick revision from 8 to 9 o'clock. Okay, this is day 12 schedule, and now coming to the day 13. Coming to the day 13, you will go through thermodynamics from physics from 11 to 1, S block elements from 2 to 4, and again thermodynamics from 5 to 7. Time for a quick screenshot. Okay, so coming to the day 14, you will again go with the vector algebra, and coming to the physics from 11 to 1, you'll go with the kinetic theory, and P blocks from P block elements from 2 o'clock to 4 o'clock. Okay, coming to the day 15, this is the last day for your vector algebra, so make sure you thoroughly prepare with your formulae. And coming to 11 to 1, you'll go with the waves and prepare very well, because a few important bits will be asked from the waves also. And from 2 to 4, you'll be preparing the questions from P block elements. Okay, coming to the day 16 schedule, you will start with your probability. Probability is, of course, one of the most easiest concept and chapter from mathematics. And after this, from 11 to 1, you'll go with the ray optics and optical instruments. You'll repeat the same from 5 to 7. And in between, from 2 to 4, you will go with the environmental chemistry. So coming to the day 17, you will go with the probability again and wave optics from 11 to 1 and wave optics from 5 to 7, and 2 to 4 you will be studying environmental chemistry. Okay, so coming to day 18, you will be covering electrical charges and fields, coming to the physics and coming to the chemistry. Organic chemistry is one of the most important chapter coming to chemistry, so you'll be covering it from 2 to 4 on day 18. And coming to 19, you'll be covering electrostatic potential and capacitance from 11 to 1 and organic chemistry from 2 to 4. Okay, so coming to day 20, you will be covering current electricity from physics and organic chemistry from your chemistry. And probability, today is the last day for probability, and on day 21, you'll be starting a pair of straight lines. It is also important concept. And from 11 to 1, you will be studying moving charges and magnetism. And from 2 to 4, you'll be studying solid state. Okay, so time for a quick screenshot. And coming to the day 22, you'll again start your day with your pair of straight lines. And from 11 to 1, you'll go with the magnetism and matter. And from 2 to 4, you'll be studying solutions. And from 5 to 7, you'll be again going with the magnetism and matter. And there's a quick revision from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. Okay, so coming to the day 23 schedule, from 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. again, you'll go with a pair of straight lines. And from 8 to 10, again, pair of straight lines. From 11 to 1, electromagnetic induction, which you'll be repeating from 5 to 7 also. And from 2 to 4, you'll be covering the topic of electrochemistry and chemical kinetics. Okay, so coming to the day 24 schedule, you will be covering alternating current from physics and surface chemistry from chemistry. Okay, I hope that's clear. So coming to the day 25, you will be covering calculus. Okay, you are starting calculus. Okay, day 24 is the end of a pair of straight length revision. You will be starting calculus from day 25, and coming to the day 25, 6 to 7 calculus, 8 to 10 calculus, 11 to 1 is electromagnetic waves, which you will be repeating even from 5 to 7. And coming to 2 to 4, D and F blocks are very, very important, students. And coming to the day 26, you will be covering calculus from mathematics, dual nature of radiation and matter from physics, and D and F blocks from chemistry. Quick screenshot. Okay. So coming to the day 27 schedule, you will be covering calculus from mathematics, atoms, and from physics, and biomolecules from your chemistry. Okay. So coming to day 28, calculus from mathematics, nuclei from physics, halogens and halcones from the chemistry. Coming to day 28, calculus, like this is the last day for your calculus, so revise thoroughly. And semiconductor electronics from your physics and organic compounds from your chemistry. And coming to the last day of your schedule, from morning 6 a.m. to 7 a.m., whatever topics you are feeling weak or whatever topics you wanted to study again, you can revise them here. And from 8 to 10, again, revision time. From 11 to 1, go with your communication systems. From 2 to 4, organic compounds. From 5 to 7, communication systems again. Last but not least, end of the day, 8 to 9 will be your revision time. So, yeah. This is the perfect schedule for 30-day MCET preparation for MPC students for both AP and TS. This is like one of the best schedule I can share with you. Okay, I'm not going to drop a PDF. Like if you want PDF separately, please do mail me. My mail address is going to be in the comment section below, because if I drop this PDF in the description box, it will be misused and it will be also used. It may be also used by other YouTubers, so I don't want that to happen. So if you want it specially, please do let me know in the comment section below by giving your email address, so that I'll be sharing with you personally through your email address. And this is specially for MPC students, and BIPC schedule is going to come up in the video, so stay tuned, watch this video till the end. Now we are going to start with the BIPC schedule. Okay, so coming to the BIPC schedule, so here is the BIPC schedule. Okay, so coming to the BIPC schedule, day 1, you will be starting your day from 6 to 7, and you'll be studying diversity in living world from botany. And from 7 to 8, you'll have a quick fresh up and you'll have your breakfast and resume back to your studies from 7 from 8 o'clock. From 8 to 10, you'll be studying diversity of living world from zoology. Okay, so till now you've studied botany, now it'll be the turn of zoology. Okay, after this, you will be taking a quick break from 10 to 11. From 11 to 1, you'll be studying physical world, and then from 1 to 2, you'll be having lunch break. From 2 to 4, you will have atomic structure preparation. And from 4 to 5, you'll be having a quick break again. From 5 to 7, you'll be studying physical world. And from 7 to 8, you'll be having a quick break again. From 8 to 9, whatever you've studied the entire day, that you are going to revise in this particular time, okay, from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. Okay, this is your day one schedule. Have a quick screenshot, like whenever you wanted to take a quick screenshot, just pause the video and you can take a screenshot. And now coming to the day two, again you will start studying diversity in the world of both botany in the morning, like 6 to 7, and from 8 to 10 zoology, diversity of living world, and from 11 to 1 units and measurements, from 2 to 4 atomic structure, from 5 to 7 units and measurements, and from 8 to 9 you'll have a quick revision. Day 3, coming to the day 3, you will be covering the structural organization in plants from 7 to 6 to 7 a.m. And from morning 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. you will be covering the concept of structural organization in animals. And from 11 to 1 motion in a straight line. From 2 to 4 classification of elements and periodicity in properties. From 5 to 7 motion in a straight line. And from 8 to 9 is a quick revision time. And from and on day 4, 6 to 7 structural organization in plants, 8 to 10 structural organization in animals, 11 to 1 motion in a plane, 2 to 4 chemical bonding and molecular structure, which is most important, one of the most important topic, and from 5 to 7 motion in a plane. And coming to day 5, 6 to 7 reproduction in plants, 8 to 10 animal diversity, 11 to 1 loss of motion, and same from 5 to 7 also loss of motion. And coming to 2 to 4 you will be covering chemical bonding and molecular structure. And coming to the day 6, you will be covering reproduction in plants from morning 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. animal diversity in from 8 to 10, from 11 to 1 work, energy and power, 2 to 4 you will be covering states of matter, gases and liquids, which is also one of the most important topic, and from again 5 to 7 you'll be covering work, energy and power. And coming to day 7, plant systematics from 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. animal diversity from 10 a.m. to 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. system of particles and rotational motion from 11 to 1, and from 2 to 4 you'll be covering stoichiometry, from 5 to 7 you'll be covering system of particles and rotational motion. Coming to the day 8, you'll be covering plant systematics, animal diversity, oscillations, and thermodynamics. If you want to take a screenshot, you can also go back and or pause the video and take it, no issues. And coming to day 9, you'll be covering cell structure and function, locomotion and reproduction in protozoa, gravitation, and thermodynamics. Okay, this is the timing and these are the topics which are need to be covered in that particular time. Okay, so coming to the day 10, cell structure and function, locomotion and reproduction in protozoa, mechanical properties of solids, chemical equilibrium and acid bases from chemistry, mechanical properties of solids from physics. Coming to day 11, internal organization of plants, biology and human welfare, mechanical property of fluids and hydrogen and its compounds. Coming to day 12, you will be covering internal organization of plants, biology and human welfare, thermal properties of matter, and S block elements. S block elements, like all these block elements like S, P, F, are very, very important students. Give a special attention to all of these concepts. And coming to day 13 schedule, plant ecology, type study of Periplanta americana, thermodynamics as block elements. And coming to day 14 schedule, plant ecology, type study of Periplanta americana, kinetic theory and P block elements from chemistry. Coming to day 15th schedule, plant physiology, ecology and environment waves, P block elements. You'll be covering these on day 15th. Coming to day 16th, plant physiology, ecology and environment, ray optics and optical instruments. Sorry, my bad, spelling mistake. Okay, environmental chemistry, ray optics and optical instruments. Like these are the topics which you're going to cover on day 16th. Coming to day 17th, genetics from 6 to 7, human anatomy and physiology from 8 to 10, wave optics from 11 to 1, which you'll be repeating even from 5 to 7 in the evening, and from 2 to 4 you'll be covering environmental chemistry. Okay, so coming to day 18, genetics, human anatomy and physiology, electric charges and fields, organic chemistry. These you will be covering on day 18. Coming to day 19, molecular biology, human anatomy and physiology, electrostatic potential and capacitance, organic chemistry will be the schedule of your day 19. Coming to the day 20, molecular biology, human anatomy and physiology, current electricity, organic chemistry will be the schedule of your day 20. Coming to day 21, biotechnology, human anatomy and physiology, moving charges and magnetism, last but not least, solid state from your chemistry. Coming to day 22 schedule, biotechnology, human anatomy and physiology. See students, human anatomy I've repeated more than 3 days. This should understand the with the help of this you should understand the importance of this concept. Okay, magnetism and matter solutions will be the schedule of day 22. Coming to day 23, microbes and human welfare, human anatomy and physiology, electromagnetic induction, electrochemistry and chemical kinetics. Coming to day 24, microbes and human welfare, again human anatomy and physiology, alternating current, surface chemistry. Coming to day 25, human reproduction, very, very important topic, electromagnetic waves, B and F block is the schedule for your day 25 for BIPC students. So coming to the day 26, genetics, dual nature of radiation and matter, D and F block. Okay, so coming to day 27, applied biology, biomolecules and atoms. Coming to day 28, you can revise whatever topics you want. Like if you are feeling you need a bit more time for any particular topic, you can use this particular time for your revision. Okay, and on day 28 you'll be covering nuclei, halolanes and halcolanes. This is the schedule for day 28. So coming to day 29, you'll be covering up the topics of semiconductor electronics and organic compounds from chemistry. Okay, So coming to the last day of your revision, you will be covering communication systems and organic compounds. Okay, so yeah, this is the perfect schedule for the students of MCET, both AP and TS, and I've already given the preparation schedule of both by PC as well as MPC students. So from tomorrow, we are going to start the crash course, and do follow the crash course. It is completely 30 days free crash course, and you can follow us the crash course, and you'll be you can watch those crash course videos on our channel. What you need to do is just subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so that whenever I upload MCET videos or any other useful videos, you'll be getting notifications and you'll be notified so that you'll never miss any update from our channel. So, and any help, I am always there for you guys. Any help, our channel is always ready to help you guys out. So one help and one request from you people is please watch every MCET videos and get good marks. If you people get good marks, that's the greatest help you can do to us as a teacher. Okay, so please watch the video completely, try to understand the concept. If you have any query, you can feel free to let me know in the comment section below, or you can also mail me. The mail address is going to be in the description box below. Do check it out. And students who want to get above 120 or above 130 out of 160 in your MCET exams, you have to follow the study material for MCET, which is given by Best Way to Study, and also you have to follow last 10 to 15 years previous year's papers, because then you can easily crack the exam by getting 120 plus marks in your MCET. And also, if you want the personal guidance of for MCET or personal coaching, then you can feel free to let me know by mailing through my mail address. So yeah, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Okay, the more likes, the more videos from Best Way to Study regarding MCET. Okay, so that's why like the video and share with all your friends and classmates. So yeah, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video.